stress is an individual's job and working environment. According to research, a job burnout, it is defined as a state of physical, emotional, and mental exhaustion, which results from long-lasting and direct confrontation with people as an emotionally overwhelming situation. In another definition, job burnout is a psychological syndrome in response to chronic job interpersonal stress. From another perspective, it is a syndrome including emotional exhaustion, depersonalization and feeling of failure in individual achievement, which happens in helping professions serving a large population. Being burned out means feeling empty, devoid of motivation, and beyond caring. People experiencing burnout often don't see any hope of positive change in their situations. If excessive stress is like drowning in responsibilities, burnout is being dried up. While you're usually aware of being under a lot of stress, you don't notice burnout when it happens. So the purpose of this research is to determine the impact of burnout level of the personnel in the Department of Education, its impact to their work performance and life satisfaction level. And to achieve this aim, the following sub-aims will be studied. What is the respondents' burnout level according to job burnout and according to emotional exhaustion? Is there a significant difference with the respondents' burnout level, job burnout, and emotional exhaustion when grouped according to rank? Is there a significant relationship between the respondents' burnout level, job burnout, and emotional exhaustion, and life satisfaction level? What is the effect of the respondents' burnout level to their work performance evaluation? Burnout level according to job burnout. In the burnout scale, 28 to 38, no job stress. Scale 39 to 50, low amount of job-related stress. And scale 51 to 70, moderate amount of stress. High amount of job-related stress is given a scale of 71 to 90, and dangerous amount of stress is given 91 to 100 scale. Table 1 respondents' burnout level according to job burnout and emotional exhaustion. Table 1. Choose the burnout level of the 150 respondents according to the job burnout and emotional exhaustion. It shows that the respondents get a mean job burnout score of 74.71 with a standard deviation of 18.099, which implies that the respondents get a high amount of job-related stress. It also shows that respondents get a mean emotional exhaustion score of 73.85 with a standard deviation of 16,524, which implies that the respondents have a high amount of job-related stress. The result shows that respondents get a high amount of job-related stress, both in job burnout and emotional exhaustion. And this result is similar to the study of Doherty, 1993, where defined burnout has been found to occur among individuals who work with people in emotionally charged situations. It is prominent in the human service professions, such as nursing, paramedics, teaching, school, work, and counseling, where extensive and direct face-to-face contact with other individuals is involved. It is considered to be a response to the chronic stress of dealing with other people, particularly when they are troubled or are having problems. Maslach and Schioffini, 1993. Burnout is likely to occur in people who feel overworked and unappreciated, Alton, 2002. Friedenberger, 1974, added that the dedicated and the researchers have identified a range of supportive behaviors provided to individuals in need. These supportive behaviors have been further categorized into two key types of support, emotional and instrumental support. Emotional support is information obtained from others that one is respected and accepted. Chikik et al., 1997. This type of support suggests to individuals they are valued by another. In contrast, instrumental support includes a wide range of activities concerning the practical help one is given from the others. House, 1981. Chikik et al., 1997. Fuchs, 1982. Such activities include the help with work responsibilities, advice in involving in solving problems and sharing of knowledge. In addition, there are two main sources of prone to suffering burnout because we work too much, too long, and too intensely. Support work-based support, supervisors, co-workers, and non-work-based support. Significant difference with the respondents' burnout level, job burnout, and emotional exhaustion in group according to RAC. The null hypothesis, there is no significant difference with the respondents' burnout level, job burnout, and emotional exhaustion in group according to RAC. The alternative hypothesis, there is a significant difference with the respondents' burnout level, job burnout, and emotional exhaustion in group according to RAC. Thus, statistics, one-way analysis of variance or the ANOVA. So, here is table 4, the analysis of variance of the respondents' burnout level, job burnout in group according to RAC. This table shows the analysis of variance of the respondents' burnout level, job burnout in group according to RAC. It shows that it has an F value of 28.783 with a P value of 0.00, which is less than 0.05. It implies that there is highly significant difference among the different ranks, the supervisor, the teacher, and principal in terms of their job burnout. Choose the Duncan multiple range test of the ranks in terms of their job burnout. It shows that the three ranks have differences on their job burnout level. It shows that the principal has the highest job burnout level with a mean value of 87.53, while the supervisor has the lowest job burnout level with a mean value of 63.83. Analysis of variance of the respondents' burnout level, emotional exhaustion, when grouped according to RAC. Table 6 shows the analysis of variance of the respondents' burnout level, emotional exhaustion, when grouped according to RAC. It shows that it has an F value of 38.928 with a P value of 0.00, which is less than 0.05. It implies that there is a highly significant difference among the different ranks, the supervisor, the teacher, and principal, in terms of emotional exhaustion. So to identify the difference among the three ranks, the researcher used the Duncan multiple range test. So table 7 shows the Duncan multiple range test of the ranks in terms of their emotional exhaustion. It shows the three ranks of differences on their emotional exhaustion level. It shows that the principal has the highest emotional exhaustion level with a mean value of 86.53, while the supervisor has the lowest job burnout level with a mean value of 61.89. Relationship between the respondents' burnout level, job burnout and emotional exhaustion, and life satisfaction level. Table 2, relationship between the respondents' burnout level, job burnout and emotional exhaustion, and life satisfaction level. The table 2 shows the relationship between the respondents' burnout level, job burnout and emotional exhaustion, and life satisfaction level. The result shows that job burnout and life satisfaction level got a p-value of 0.00, less than 0.05, implies that there is a highly significant relationship between the job burnout and life satisfaction level of the respondents. The results also show that emotional exhaustion and life satisfaction level with a p-value of 0.00, which is also less than 0.05, implies that there is a highly significant relationship between the emotional exhaustion and life satisfaction level of the respondents. And based on the results above, it shows that there is a significant relationship between respondents' burnout level, job burnout, and emotional exhaustion and life satisfaction level. The effect of the respondents' burnout level to their work performance evaluation. So to assess the effect and the impact of the variables, the researchers conducted the first a-person correlation coefficient test to assess if there is a significant relationship between the two variables, and it has been shown in the table. If the relationship between the two variables, then the researcher needs to check the R value and its interpretation. Interpretation, the negative inverse relationship, positive direct relationship, close to zero weak relationship, and close to one strong relationship. Table 3 shows the effect of the respondents' burnout level to their work performance evaluation. It shows that job burnout and work performance evaluation has an R value of negative 0.411, which is negative, and it's close to zero. The result shows that there is negatively weak relationship between the job burnout and work performance evaluation. It implies that as the job burnout level of the respondents increases, then their work performance evaluation decreases. Or as the job burnout level of the respondents decreases, then their work performance evaluation increases. Since there is a weak relationship between the two variables, implies that there are other factors aside from job burnout that affects the work performance evaluation of the respondents. It also shows that emotional exhaustion and work performance evaluation has an R value of negative 0.408, which is negative and it is close to zero. The result shows that there is a negatively weak relationship between the emotional exhaustion and work performance evaluation. It implies that as an emotional exhaustion level of the respondents increases, then their work performance evaluation decreases, or as the emotional exhaustion of the respondent decreases, then their work performance evaluation increases. Since there is a weak relationship between the two variables, it implies that there are other factors aside from emotional exhaustion that affects the work performance evaluation of the respondents. In summary, respondents with low burnout level, job burnout, and emotional exhaustion have a higher performance evaluation in their work, while respondents with higher burnout level, job burnout, and emotional exhaustion have a lower performance evaluation in their work.